Welcome to the Dennis and Judy Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, Value City NJ, with 9 locations in New Jersey or online at valuecitynj.com. Don't forget to subscribe to the show so you'll never miss a minute. New Jersey
101.5. Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app, New Jersey. Chime time is 10:09. It's the Dennis and Judy Show. I'm Dennis Malloy.
I'm Judy Franco. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the program. It's a winter wonderland outside, Dennis. I'm sure you've noticed. I don't know how much we have out there. It looks like probably about the same as you guys got. Last night before I went to sleep, I was like, oh, it's a coating to an inch. You know that old saying, a coating
to an
inch?
That's what I thought it was going to be, but it looked like about... By me, about 3 or 4, and probably maybe a little less here. I think Burlington County got a heavy dumping in the middle of the night, according to one of the weather people in Philly. So, yeah, we got 3 or 4, and I think that's... Dan said 2 to 4 throughout the state, and he was, as usual, spot on.
But I thought it would be different near the shore, but it wasn't. This morning...
One inch or 1 or 2 there? So you got 1 or 2 by you?
It looks like more than that, but I don't know. I wasn't out there measuring. But it was definitely enough so that people started texting me this morning. Do you need me to come and shovel for you? Do you want to use my snowblower? Blah, blah, blah. So I started thinking, you know, and we used to really look forward to, in the olden days when my kids were growing up, a lot of teenagers would knock on the door and say, can I shovel? And, you know, you'd give them $20. It was a big job. And that was a nice payday in those days. Mm. So, you know, sometimes the snow would be, I don't know, you'd have like a foot of snow.
If you had that same house, what do you think it would cost you today? 50?
At least. Yeah. I mean, there were 2 kids, too. You know? So you got to give them each, I don't know, 50.
And then maybe? It went from kids doing it, which, you know, growing up, that's what we did. My kids did it, too. To now it's landscapers with a pickup truck with a plow on it, and that's you pay,
which
those.
Is easier, let's face it.
And he has, you know? 3 you know, illegal migrants with him, and boom, it's done. And I don't ask questions, I don't look for papers, I just say,
oh, you don't ask to see their social security card.
But do kids still do that?
That's a very good question. The person that asked me is somebody who was asking me on behalf of her husband, who does a lot of odd jobs, handing me on work and stuff like that. But I don't know that kids do it. It's a good question. So what did you do about the snow cleanup this morning? Do you do it yourself? Did you buy yourself a snowblower finally? And you're, you know, if you bought a snowblower in the last 10, 15 years, you cannot wait. You would be fighting people off because you can't wait to break that thing out.
I got one a couple of years ago that I saw. Spadia had one. And it was battery powered. So I never wanted to get a snowblower with the gas and and all that. But the battery powered ones are pretty good. And it doesn't handle a whole lot. It'll handle like what we got today. It'll handle a driveway. My driveway has gravel, so I can.
But I feel like a blower would be the perfect thing. Better than a shovel for a gravel driveway.
There's gravel driveway, you have to like go down with the shovel to the gravel and pull it off.
I cannot believe you had gravel in your old house.
No, that's paved.
But it used to be gravel.
Used to be gravel because
I know, because I had gravel for a while.
The purple gravel.
And we moved into a house with purple gravel. And it took us maybe 6 months of living in that house with 4 kids to realize, yeah, this ain't going to be good.
Well, we were told you can't pave it over.
I remember. Well, you have a whole...
The Pine Lands Commission said you can't. And then somebody said, BS, and they had it paved. And everybody's like, you got it paved, I'm getting paved. And everybody got it paved and got rid of the gravel. But where I live now, it's all gravel and it's a horseshoe and it's uphill.
Who came up with that idea?
The gravel driveway?
Yeah.
Somebody wanted to save money on paving.
It's So stupid.
Well, I don't know how much it would cost to pave my driveway, but probably a good chunk of change. All right, so how was it by you? What part of Jersey you're from, and what did you get? And who does the shoveling or the clearing? Do kids still do that? If you have teenage kids, you send them out with a shovel and say, oh, go make some money? Gary's calling. Hey, Gary.
Good morning, JD. DJ, you know what I say?
No.
Shovel, plow, plow, plow. Give me the money.
Now, that's your business, right? You're a landscaper, so this time of year you do snow plowing.
Yeah, you know, my insurance was so expensive last year, and it is again. I lost about $22,000 last year because I can't cancel my policy because they don't want to write it anymore, the liability for plowing. So last year was a catastrophe.
Yeah, nothing. No snow.
So this year, it's the first storm, and you know what? Even though I'm doing 31, 32 years plowing now, You're a little rusty when it's the first snowstorm of the year. So I go nice and easy.
Especially because you didn't do anything last year.
Yeah.
Can we imagine that, though, paying $22,000 or whatever for insurance and you have no work?
I pay a little over $24,000 just for liability.
Yeah,
for
that's the day I sell
flat.
My plow.
Gary.
Move to Idaho.
What do you do with gravel driveway?
Well, if you want to do the right job, you should always put a coat of blacktop on the bottom. And then what we do is we take the pea gravel or 3/8 gravel chip and we actually roll it into the hot asphalt. So then it sticks to that.
Okay, right. Yeah, that's great. If somebody has a gravel driveway, how do we remove the snow from it? Forget the pea, then the pack, whatever. Somebody's got a gravel driveway with nothing underneath. How do we get the snow off?
I just raise my plates about 1 inch or so off the ground. And you just try to skim as much as you can.
Right.
That's the best you can do.
I had a neighbor across the street. He would do that, but it still ended up with tons of gravel in my lawn from when he would push it forward. Yeah.
It's time to pave that driveway.
I just put new gravel down last year.
Why?
Because the old gravel was all pulverized. Yeah. I should have just paved it. You're right.
Yeah, here's the problem. There's no substitute for experience. And, you know, at the end of the day, I'm doing this 37 years in my landscaping, 31, 32, plowing. You got to go easy, man. If you're going to charge people a good amount of money, do the right job. And this goes throughout my business. And that's the way it is. But you get these nomad people that just go in, they terrorize your property, and then you still got to pay. And you don't even know if they have the right insurance.
You're up in Colts Neck.
Terrorize your property.
Is it terrorize or pillarize? I
thought he said terrorize. I'm like, what are they, planting landmines? What are they?
IEDs.
And here's the other word I use. My guys, the people guerrillarize the equipment. They destroy my stuff, and they don't say nothing to me. Yeah, so that's where the...
Yeah, because it's not theirs. So. But Gary, in Colts Neck, how much snow did you get?
I would say about 3 inches, actually, on my table. But it's starting to melt. But, boy, if you don't get this stuff up soon, it's going to be really terrible tonight and tomorrow.
Yeah, it's supposed to really get cold. All right, Gary, stay safe. Thanks so much for the call. How bad was it where you, and how bad are the road conditions by you? And who does the walkway and the driveway in your house? Do you have kids in the neighborhood that still have a shovel and knock on doors? Now, in my neighborhood, it's on a main road, so it's hard to have a cohesive neighborhood feeling. But a new neighbor across the street, a couple moved in. They have a 15, 16-year-old boy. And then across the street from right next to them, there's a girl who's 16 or 17. Do I knock on the door and go, hey, does your kid want to make some money?
That's hard because the 15-year-old or 16-year-old is not the same as your 16-year-old when you were... No, I wouldn't. The parent might be in 2023, Dennis, parent might be offended. What do you think? My kid's an illegal alien?
Well, both parents seem to be down to earth. One's a male woman. She's a letter carrier.
Okay.
The other one's a teacher, but a cool teacher.
Okay, so knock on the door and be like, hey... Just curious.
$50
Justin. $50 burning a hole in my pocket. Would Justin be? It's just Dennis. Have you met a 16-year-old in 2023?
No, yes. Some of them work at the supermarket by me, and it's
yeah. They could barely move their arms to get change out of the register.
If you go to the supermarket by me after 6 or 7 o'clock at night, I call it Zombie Land. It's all 16 or 17-year-old kids, and they're zombies. You make eye contact with them, and they go,
Yeah.
And you try to speak to them, and they're like, why are you talking to me?
Frightening. Yeah. They're so scared.
All right. How is the snow by you? How are the roads by you? And do kids still shovel? 1-800-283-101.5, 1080.5. So, how much snow did you get, and how are the roads by you? I live in Burlington County. We got about 3 or 4 inches of snow in the Medford area. Drove 295 for about 30 miles, and it was wet with a little bit of slush on all the lanes here and there, but it wasn't bad. You could do 60 without a problem. But once there was a car went into the ditch. There's a stretch of 295 where it's very wooded. It's around Columbus. I think it's just before the Columbus, if you head north, before the Columbus exit. Or maybe it's right after. Yeah, just before. So there's a median there, and it's wooded. And it's a little lower than, but little below sea level there. So a car slid off the left lane into the woods down the ravine, only about like 10 feet, 15 feet below the road surface, but it was a small car, and it was tucked in there pretty good. So there was fire trucks and ambulances and tow trucks. I don't know if the person was hurt, but that was
a little scary.
Yeah, had to dodge a few trees. The car didn't look too banged up, but it's going to be a hell of a job getting it out of there. So if
you this morning, I noticed you were serious driving in.
Yes, very serious.
Why?
I was behind when I spoke to you, I was behind a plow, and I didn't know to pass the plow or to just let it in.
And sometimes do you know that you never know when you're behind a plow? If it's like a plow guy or like a guy learning to be a plow guy.
Well, he
doesn't it sometimes look like plow guy school?
Yeah. And respect to all the NJDOT.
God bless them. I'm not saying no.
Yeah.
I'm just saying sometimes you're behind a plow guy going, oh, this guy's first day on the job is today.
Shane is calling from Belmar. Hi, Shane.
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Not too bad. A few months ago, I have four young children, 11, 9, 7, and 5, two boys and three girls. And when the leaves started to fall, I made three of my kids go with me. They grabbed a few of their friends. We had about 5 or 6 kids out there. They all made about $100 each. And last night when it started to snow, they were like, Dad, can we go shoveling snow? I'm like, absolutely, but unfortunately, it's really not an option with this rain. So... But they're looking forward to Friday. We're supposed to get 4 inches, and they want to go out this weekend and shovel snow.
That's great. So when you took them in the fall, they raked other people's leaves and made $100 each?
Well, I did the majority of the work. I take leaf blowers with me. They're going through the motions, but I'm teaching them. You know, be out there, do the work, you get paid.
If they slack off a little, do you shoot that leaf blower right in their face for a couple seconds?
Absolutely.
All right.
That's what to do.
Good dad.
That is what to do.
All right, Shane. That's great. Do other parents, you noticing other parents doing this or no?
Believe it or not, I don't think you do Facebook, but the local town Facebook pages, people are requesting it.
Yeah, requesting it. Like but
They're like, hey, any kids out there want to come out and, you know, shovel some snow? Or I had two people ask me today if my kids wanted to come, and I had to say, well, they only have a 2-hour delay, so it's really not enough time to do anything.
And how old's your youngest?
My youngest is 5. She doesn't go out. But my 7-year-old girl goes out, my 9-year-old boy, and my 11-year-old boy.
Okay, let me just say this. You're doing something right, because I had 4 kids. Three of them would go out, they'd whine about it, I don't want them, and my husband would be like, you know, I'm a softie, I'd be like, right. Okay, come back, get enough more marshmallows. Yeah,
hot cocoa.
But daddy is like, no, get out there. But one of the kids, and I'm sure you can guess which one, whined and kicked and screamed so much that it was worse after he, I think he got snow from the neighbors and put it on the driveway. You might as well not have him out there because he made it worse. And I remember saying, like, this kid is getting away scot-free because I can't even have him out there. But literally, and it was not that he meant to do a bad job at it.
He was just horrible at it.
He was horrible.
All right, Shane, good luck. Thank you. Stay.
Judy, hold on. Yeah. Judy, that's my 11-year-old. My 11-year-old is the worst when it comes to work ethics. He has zero. Yeah. My 9-year-old is out there. He's out there with me 99% of the time, no matter what I'm doing.
Can you change that, Shane? Can you work on that or no?
It's a personality
thing.
Dennis,
I try daily. I don't know if I'm ever going to succeed.
Shane, I would love to give you positive advice about this, but all I have to tell you is that one in my family is a grown-up, and it hasn't changed much.
And I don't foresee it changing.
All right, Shane, thank you. Appreciate the call. That's his oldest.
I mean, and we, Dennis, I mean, it's a personality thing. It's like me, you know, I don't like to get out of bed. I don't. I'm always going to be a person who doesn't like to get out of bed. I will get out of bed. Doesn't mean I like it.
Phil's in Clinton. Hi, Phil.
Hey, how are you guys?
Good. How are you?
Hey.
Good. Thank you. So I have my son with me, and he'd rather come to work with me instead of going to school.
And what do? Do you plow snow for a living?
Well, yeah, part of my living, landscape construction.
Right.
And he tells me daily, I don't want to go to school. I want to go with you, Dad. And then he gives it to my wife, too, and he gives her the riot act also. I don't want to go to school. I'd rather go to work with Dad.
How old is he?
He's 10.
Honestly, if you were allowed to, Dennis.
Why not? Why
just
not?
Just freaking, okay, listen. Everything he's going to learn in public school in New Jersey from now until 12th grade, you could teach it. I mean, the parts that he really needs to learn, right?
Yeah, not you could all teach him while he's in the truck.
You could teach him in the truck. You're not going to teach him how to spot an abusive relationship or why everybody's the same gender.
Use the right pronouns.
None of that. But everything he needs to learn, put him in the truck. He'll learn in the truck. Dude, he is going to take over your business. Why does he need to go to school? Seriously.
Right. I teach him honest communications with people, too, you know?
Yeah, something's sorely lacking.
Well, an alternative way, Dennis, alternative way of communicating with people that they don't teach you in school anymore. You know what I mean?
I'm afraid to guess. That. All right, Phil, we got to run, but thank you. Keep up the great work. Thanks so much for the call.
You know.
He means give him the look. Like, yeah. you don't have to say too much. Yeah. All right, Mike, Albert, hang on. How much snow did you get? How bad are the roads by you? And do kids still clear the snow? How do you get it cleared by you? It's 10:30, New Jersey, 101.5. Who registered? Dennis and Judy Show, 10:36. Portions of the show made possible by Trinity Rehab. Here's some exciting news. Trinity Rehab is now fully in-network with Blue Cross Blue Shield. Call today for your same-day appointment. It's never been easier to go to physical therapy. Locations all over New Jersey. That's trinity-rehab.com. Dennis and Judy Show. I don't have the snow. It was nasty enough. Somebody would say, oh, it's only a couple inches. And for me, it's not the couple of inches that bothers me. It's the driving an hour on the interstate to get here while it's happening.
Yeah, that's why I love weekend snowstorms. People are like, why do you want it to snow? I'm like, because if you want, you can just sit in your house and look watch outside. The snow fall and build a fire and eat hot cocoa.
So how was it by you? How are the roads by you? And do we still have an army of teenagers that go out and shovel snow? Albert and Tin Falls, hang on, we'll talk to you next. Mike on the Parkway. Hey, Mike.
How you doing?
Good, how are you? Where are you at on the Parkway?
I just got off the Parkway. I'm on 138 right now, actually headed into Eatontown.
Oh, okay.
It's raining over here, but I also plow. I plowed from 6 to 6 in the morning.
But for yourself, for your own business, or for the state?
Yes, no, it's my own. It's my own little thing that I bought the plow 3 years ago. It sat in my yard for 3 years.
Yeah.
My wife wanted me to get rid of it. She said it's an eyesore. She'll be happy next week when the checks come in.
Yeah.
How much you think you'll make this week?
Well, the company that I work for, I also plow the lot. Okay? They pay me $120 an hour to plow their lot.
All right. And then you got side jobs on your own.
Right. I did about three or four driveways at $100 a piece. You know what I mean? So
yeah, that's not bad. What do you have, a Ford F-250?
All in all, it was a productive night.
Good. Good.
I love that you always ask them what kind of truck they have, Dennis. Only a guy would care about that, you know?
Judy wants to know if you have a Ford
F-250. Judy wants to know if you have a Peterbilt.
I got a Ford F-250.
Yeah, see?
But isn't a Peterbilt one of the ones you always
That's the big 18-wheeler.
Peterbilt is a... That's a big truck.
Yeah.
I know.
Jesus.
The one with the mud flaps with the naked girl on it. That's the Peterbilt.
Yes.
Yeah. What do I know?
Yeah. That could be one of them.
What's your regular job, Mike?
I work for a company delivering awning products.
Oh. All right. Awning products?
Yeah. Retractable awnings for houses and awnings for stores. I work for a company that does that out of Jersey.
Very good. All right. Thank you, Mike. Appreciate the call. I remember my dad making a big deal when we got awnings in South Philly on our row home. We got these blue fiberglass awnings, and he was so happy.
Oh, my God.
Because, A.
I used to have that in Bradley.
Yeah?
I still have an awning, Den. You know, I have one of those retractable ones.
Oh, I love those. I don't think I can get one.
Like, why?
And not enough header space for the thing to attach. I don't know. The ceiling's too low.
You can. Oh, Dennis, think positively.
Well, he was so happy that the sun would not get in the house anymore and the rain would stay off of the air conditioner, which was 32,000 BTUs, which was the biggest one in the neighborhood. He was very proud of that.
Oh, boy, yes. That's something to be proud of, for sure.
Albert is in Tintin Flask, as Judy always says, kids, ask your grandparents. Albert in Tintin Falls, hi.
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing all right. It's just raining over here now. It's just a slushy mess.
Yeah.
But I heard you talking about the rocks in the driveways. I've done snow removal with snow blowers, and if you look at the snow blower on the front of the right and left side, there's actually guides that you can adjust to raise it up so you don't hit the rocks, and it just guides over them and it cleans it off pretty close to the rocks.
Well, I'll have to borrow it for my family member who's
as long.
Yeah. Even the have you tried the
that,
have you tried the battery ones, or you got gas powered?
No, I'd rather use gas.
Yeah.
Nice. It'd be out there in the freezing cold, and it shuts off with a battery. You got to find a battery. Batteries don't like the cold most of the time.
Yeah, that's why I'm getting a whole fleet of EVs.
A whole fleet of them.
The state, he's, you know, can't sell a gas powered one at 2035. Yeah. What a dumb thing.
When I started to do the snow, I bought a machine. It was like $500 brand new. My ex was like, "Oh, you're not going to make money this or that." And then we got this huge snowstorm. We had like 2 feet of snow, and the first job was $500. And I'm like, what are you talking about?
How long have you been divorced?
Well, I never got married, so.
Oh.
Not with her.
All right. Yeah. Yeah, well, she wasn't right, apparently.
Yeah, she wasn't.
All right. Thanks, Albert. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Jason's in Tabernacle. Oh, it's our friend Jason.
Hey, Chase.
Good morning, guys.
Hi.
How you been?
I'm good. I'm riding around in my Freightliner. I can't afford no Peterbilts or Kenworths, but I do have two friends, my buddy Blaze and my buddy Diaz. They got W9 Kenworths, but I can't afford that, so I ride around in the Freightliner. It's the economy.
Well, you know Blaze has to have the best truck of all.
And Judy's impressed with the W9.
Oof, I can't believe it. Fuely heads.
You got to be careful with the chrome women. So they got heavier women that are chrome as well. You can put on the mud flaps, and then they got stickers that say no fat chicks. So you have to be careful because you can offend people with the wrong mud flap weights.
So they have the silhouette of a heavy woman on the mud flaps now.
and they have a skinny one. Yeah, so you have to be careful because you can offend people. You know, I don't want anybody to get offended. Or maybe they did it to include everybody. I'm not sure.
Yeah, oh, yeah, they put the heavy one on there to because that's what most, you know, people are today.
But doesn't it say no fat chicks? I got whole confused from this whole thing.
They do. They got stickers and stuff you can put on the back of the tail of the trailer that say no fat chicks. How do you like my driving, et cetera? Yeah. Oh, I don't want to offend nobody, so I don't put that stuff on my truck.
Yeah.
Okay.
Neither does Judy.
Very nice guy.
All right, Jason, where are you at today?
I'm heading up to Delanco. I had 6 drops on my truck. My last drop isn't until 5 o'clock tonight. I'm so angry, but that's okay.
Delanco, you might run into some flooding. They had some serious flooding there. Yeah.
There was. That's what I hear.
All right. Well, stay safe, Jason. Thanks for the call to New Jersey 101.5.
What's Delanco? Is that like near where you used to live?
Yeah, it's near Delran.
I always get that one.
Well, Delran got the first dibs on the good name because it's at the convergence of the Delaware and the Rancocas River. And Delanco was like, well, we're at the convergence of the creek and the river, too. What do we do?
And they were like, sorry, we used it.
Yeah, and they go, well, go for the middle or go for Anco. So they got, yeah.
So all they got was Anco.
And then if there's another town, it would be Del Ass.
By the way, same thing happened to me. My last name.
Oh, the Franco?
I was like, I want Frill Ran. And they were like, oh, we got his Anco. So Franco.
I got
so
you.
So dumb.
Very dumb. 10:44. Dennis Malloy here for Brightview Senior Living. They offer a variety of vibrant senior living communities, and residents can enjoy true independent living while relaxing with friends at happy hour, enjoying chef-prepared delicious meals, and more. They also have been recognized by U.S. News and World Report for the best independent living, best assisted living, and best memory care in 2023. Get peace of mind with Brightview Senior Living. See which New Jersey community is right for you by visiting brightviewnewjersey.com. Dennis and Judy Show, 10:51. It's the January 16th is one of my mom's birthdays. Remember she had 2 birthdays?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's the cutest thing then.
Yeah. She was a little cutie. We're talking about clearing the snow. How much snow did you get by you? It seems to be turned to mostly rain, especially in the eastern half of the state toward the shore. But is it bad? Are the roads bad? And who does the clearing of the snow by you? You do it yourself? Do you have kids in the area that can do it? If you have kids, you send them out, make a couple extra bucks. Kevin's in PA. Hey, Kevin.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. So I've been turning wheels since 2:30. This is my second trip into PA. The first trip sucked because I got stuck behind the plow trucks to and from. But this trip's going good because I'm hammered down at 70.
You're what?
I'm hammered down at 70.
Oh, good. That's pretty good. What are you driving? What are you delivering?
Garbage.
Garbage.
The garbage to the landfill.
Where do you take the where do you get the garbage?
In Jersey and bring it to PA.
Well, where in Jersey? Everywhere?
Yeah, we got a lot of places. South Plainfield, Patterson.
How far into Pennsylvania do you take our garbage?
This one's going to Conestoga. It's exit... hold on. I'll tell you in a second. Exit 298 off the PA Turnpike.
Conestoga?
Yeah, Conestoga.
Isn't Conestoga a good name? A number 2 pencil.
It's where they make the pencils out of our garbage.
That's Ticonderoga.
No, but there was also Conestoga. And I want to tell you something. What did the comedian say about the number 2 pencil, Dennis?
What happened to the number 1?
No, is that the number 1 pencil? Oh, he said, not a good ending. What did he say? It was so funny, Dennis.
Kevin, yeah, Conestoga's out toward
Hey, Siri,
Lancaster.
What is Conestoga famous for?
Yeah, pretty far out there.
Yeah, all right. Thank you very much. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Yeah,
Conestoga, interesting, Dennis. When you Google Conestoga, why do you get something about Fort Ticonderoga? Aha. there's a conspiracy.
There's a connection there.
Yeah, maybe the pencil people. You know, Dennis, I always thought we were being manipulated by Big Pencil, didn't you?
Big Lead, Judy.
Big Lead. It's not really lead, it's big graphite.
We like
this. Conestoga High School is in Berwyn, PA.
Right, but then Conestoga, PA is out near Millersville and Lancaster. It's below Lancaster.
I don't know. You know what, Dennis? I'm sorry. There's something here. I know that I have a feeling Conestoga and Ticonderoga may be some kind of left-wing conspiracy. I mean, you won't see the mainstream media touching this with a 10-foot pole.
Because you're not making any sense.
Why do you think we always use number two? Excuse me. What do you think happened to number ones? Maybe they did a Jeffrey Epstein on the number one pencil.
Here's what I'm thinking. Only private schools got the number one. When public school, we got stuck with the number two. Or, you know what it is? The foreigners.
Really, no. What? Yeah. Oh.
The Europeans have the number one. We got the number
Picking
two.
Up what you're laying down now. Yeah. Yep. 100%. You know who has the number one? In spades?
Who?
The Koch brothers.
Oh, yeah.
George Soros?
Yep.
What do you think they write with in Soros' office?
Yeah, and you're busting your little point, writing with the number two. They got the number ones. They're signing the big checks and stuff. So stupid. All right.
It's so stupid, but it's so much fun.
I know. All right, listen. Have you been thinking about adding a pet to your family? My friends at Pet Center in Old Bridge know exactly how to match you with a perfect pet. They have a large selection of quality puppies. So cute. You can play with them in a separate room, but they're very, very careful on how you deal with them. They are so good. They're animal lovers, and they're amazing. And these puppies are all from USDA licensed and inspected breeders. When you bring home a Pet Center puppy, you get the most comprehensive guarantees in the market. Up-to-date vaccines, 5 generations of pedigree, and a complete homecoming kit. They also have a large selection of small animals, reptiles, birds, and tropical fish. Visit them in the shops at Old Bridge on Route 9 or at petcenternj.com. Parks Casino at Sportsbook, New Jersey. Chime time is 11:09. It's the Dennis and Judy Show. I'm Dennis Malloy. That's Judy Franco.
Well, how are you?
Well, I'm just fine, Judy. Thanks so much for asking. Yeah, so most of the snow has turned to rain, or a mix of sleet and rain, and should all be out of here by the time we're off the air at 2 o'clock. Stay safe. Be careful on the roads. There's some slushy spots where you still may go sliding off into a ditch, so be careful out there. Somebody wrote on Reddit, does anybody have any good hospital giving birth stories? My wife is about to give birth for the first time. It's our first child, blah, blah, blah.
Who would ask for giving birth stories?
People who go on Reddit.
Dumbbells.
You know, what? You don't have an aunt? You don't have a mom? You don't have a brother-in-law? Sister-in-law? They can tell you
Yeah.
What? I know. It's anyway, insane. There are plenty of good stories, and we want to hear them. If you have a good story about giving birth, 6 days in labor, husband fainted, nurse was not helpful. Everybody has a birthing story that they love to tell. Or, and I will add this into the mix, just in general, hospital stories.
Okay. I think everybody has a birth story. And here's how we're going to ask this question. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready, Judy.
You had somebody faint in the room. You almost gave birth on the floor of the hospital. You almost gave birth in a taxi cab. Your mother fainted when she heard. You thought you were having one baby. You ended up having triplet. Out of the ordinary birth stories. And here's the thing. The no death rule is in effect. The no horrible circumstances rule is in effect. Because we want fun things. I don't want, and then I was hemorrhaging and it saved my life. No. There's enough fun, good stories about giving birth, because it is such an adventure that where things turn out okay, that I don't want to hear the negative stories. I want to hear good stuff. 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number, because there's people listening to us right now, there are at least 100 people right now who almost gave birth in a car. There are a few people listening to us right now who gave birth in a car. There are some people listening to us right now who gave birth in their living room. Because guess what, people? Whether you get to the hospital or not, it's a snowstorm, whatever, somehow that baby's coming out. Even if you have to do it yourself and you're stuck in an elevator, it doesn't only happen on TV. It happens in real life, too. 1-800-283-101.5. So I'll tell you really quickly. It was one of my kids gave birth during the pandemic. And they made a very, very big deal about no oxygen in the room. And I do not even to this moment understand why. Because can you imagine if you're a mom in labor or a pregnant woman in labor and there's no oxygen because of the pandemic? I didn't understand it. Do you get that? What would oxygen?
Look, they wouldn't allow her to have extra oxygen.
They wouldn't allow oxygen in the room. The oxygen tank they usually have in the rooms or the oxygen. Oxygen could not be turned on in the room. Dennis, look, what do we know now about all the rules about the pandemic?
Stupid as all hell. Cavemen had better ideas, rules, and procedures than humans did under the guise of Dr. Anthony Fauci during 2020.
Correct. So somebody...
And all you people who believed him like a saint, I forgive you for blaming, for pointing at me for not getting vaccinated and not wearing a mask everywhere. I forgive you. Even though you won't admit you were wrong, I forgive you. Thank you.
Okay, so we're in Lenox Hill Hospital, Manhattan, and they decide, for some reason, no oxygen. Okay, my daughter's doing fine, whatever. All of a sudden, for some reason, it started to get close, and she started to get to be in active labor, and things started to get dicey, as they do in the delivery room, and that was my 10th or 11th time in the delivery room. And my son-in-law starts to feel faint. So turn to the nurse, one of the nurses, and my son-in-law doesn't feel well. Looks like he's going to pass out.
Mm.
Well, I'm sorry, no oxygen. And I'm like, is this a joke? So we waited for the obstetrician, who my daughter's very close with, to come in. And I turned to her and I said, Dr. Michelle, they're not letting oxygen. She said, she's from the islands. You put that oxygen on right now. This guy's going to
faint.
This guy's going to faint if you don't. And they gave my son-in-law the oxygen.
And your daughter was saying, grow up, Michael.
Correct. It was Jack.
Jack. Oh, yeah. I wouldn't think it was
Let's
Michael.
Go to...
Devon.
Dave. Devon.
Devon. Do you know anybody
Davin?
Else? Davin?
Davon is how you pronounce it. D-A-V-O-N. Davon.
Davon. Davon.
Do you have any... Do you know any other people named Davon?
I've seen it spelled the same, but they pronounce it different.
Yeah, I know a Devon who's... He lives in Willingboro, but you're in Tuckerton. All right, Davon, what do you got?
So, if you had my newborn, she's a year now, we decided to wait until she was born to find out the sex. We didn't let anybody know. Nobody knew. Every time we go to the doctor's office, we kept telling them, we don't want to find out. We don't want to find out. We're keeping it. We had already chose the name. Her name is Destin. Either way, it was going to be the same. It was going to be that name, boy or girl. So we get there, and the doctor, the first guy comes in, and he says, oh, so it's okay. So we're having, a little boy today. And he, like, mentioned boy. So we all, my mother-in-law, my lady, we're sitting there like, oh, man, he kind of ruined it. And we wanted a boy, but, like, if we figured, he took the element of surprise. So he said, oh, no, I don't know. He said, I'm guessing. I see, you know. He said, okay, because they write the goal, at Voorhees Virtuous, they write, like, what the plan is for the day. Obviously, it was have a baby. So when he wrote boy, so he took that off, and then they came and asked, you know, if it was a male dude, we want him circumcised. So at this point, we're like hours into her being in labor. We went on to the next day. The next day, so we don't see that doctor again. He comes in, they do the balloon, they're doing all this different stuff. You guys are going to have to go for a cesarean. And we get in there. I'm next to my lady. She's on the bed, awake, which was kind of crazy for me, sitting there and there, like, tugging, and she couldn't feel nothing. It was wild. But so, long story short, we wait, and we're like, oh, you know, it's a
we're like, the guy, he kind of gave it up. It was a boy. But no, it was a girl. And when they picked her up after and they showed the baby, I was kind of looking and I'm like, no, that's a girl? And they said, yeah, they didn't even say anything. The doctors had the mask on and they were just nodding yes. My mom, my mother-in-law, I went out to the waiting room and I told them, I said, it's a girl. And they were telling me that I was lying. It was a boy, and the doctor ruined it. And they were like, no, you're lying. And I'm crying. I'm like, I'm not lying. It's another girl. But yeah, man, that's my story.
So you guys.
Yeah, by the way, you know how confusing those genitals are when they're first born?
Really?
Yes. I'm glad to hear you say it because I looked. I was like, I really don't know what I'm looking at.
I know. I had to look like 15 times. Really? Yeah. They both have two swollen things.
Okay.
You know?
Davon.
I'm so happy. I'm so freaking happy that he agrees with me.
In that hospital, nice. It's like a fancy hotel, that hospital.
Yeah, you know, the first room, you know, where you're first expecting that, nobody had told us, but we realized that we could pull the couch out, then the one chair reclined. So me and my mom slept next to each other, my mother-in-law.
It's like a luxury suite over there.
Great.
My daughter-in-law gave birth to both
of those
kids there.
Yeah.
Davon, thank you, Davon. Great story. Appreciate the call.
Davon, I love you. Thank you for, also for...
confirming confusing genitals.
The story about the confusing genitals. No, Dennis, did you look really close when they first came out? Sometimes it's hard to tell.
Like they said, oh, it's a boy or it's a girl. When I think we knew, I don't know.
Yeah.
But I wasn't.
But
yeah,
I needed the doctor to say it almost every time. I'm like looking at it and I'm like, somebody say it because I'm not sure what's going on there. It's not always that.
Well, now they don't say it at all because... you know, the child decides
when they
grow up.
Where I am, they do. I asked the doctor the last time. I'm like, are you going to stop saying it's a girl to boy? He's like, not until the day I die.
Of course. Yeah. Sue, Linda, Terry, hang on. Crazy birth stories, crazy hospital stories. 1119. Come. Citizen Judy Show talking about birth stories and hospital stories. And as Judy stated before, the no death rule, the no horrific outcome rule is in effect. Sue is in Morristown.
Don't you like that rule that I made?
I do. When it comes to these stories, yes.
Hello.
Hi, Sue.
Hi.
Hi. Love your show.
Thank you.
About 20 years ago, we had a sweet old Karen Terrier, and he did this weird thing where he'd look up and bite like he was catching a fly, and obviously something was wrong with him. So after a long time, our vet said, you know, you shouldn't sleep with him anymore. Well, we went out. I don't drink. My wife and my friend, we all went out, came home about midnight. They had been drinking.
I'm a little uncomfortable with this sleeping with your dog, and at the end of it, there's a birth story.
No, it's not a birth story.
It's a hospital story.
It's a funny hospital story.
Okay.
And
okay.
By the way, Sue, Judy does the same thing where she bites at the air like she's chasing a fly. And it's not serious. The doctor said.
Maybe I am chasing a fly, okay? Okay. Don't mental health shame me.
So the dog bit me in the above my lip and below my nose. And the blood was pouring out.
In bed.
Yeah. So now my wife and my her good friend have been drinking, and I couldn't drive, so we had no choice. Her friend drove, got us to the hospital. Her friend is very pretty and has a way with men, and the cop pulled us over. She says, go inside. I'll take care of it. Well, she gets out of it, comes in. My wife stays with me while I'm getting stitched up. My wife says, I got to leave for a second. I'll be right back. The other girl comes in. I hear bang, bang, bang. I come out. My wife is sitting in a wheelchair because she passed out in the bathroom from looking at the blood and hit the sink, the wall, the toilet.
Oh,
it was
pretty
funny.
Wow.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound funny.
She had to sign a paper to get herself out of the hospital.
This attractive drunken friend, she's single?
She was married. I don't know if she still is, but yeah, she's pretty.
She got away with the men, too.
And what did she tell the cop?
I don't know. She just said, you know, look, we were hurrying because she was bleeding really bad, and she probably, and she got his number.
All right. Thank you, Sue. Great story. Loved it. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Terry is in Brick. Hello, Terry.
Oh, good morning.
Morning.
I had my daughter like 28 years ago, and I woke up at like 5:30 in the morning with my contractions 5 minutes apart, and my doctor said, oh, sometime tonight. But then my water broke, and they were 1 minute apart. So okay. We went right to the hospital. She was coming out before the doctor was there. But she was healthy, and after that, I had 3 more kids. All kids were under 2 hours each time. So I think it's great because I'm active and no drugs, and that's why I kept having them. Little pain.
Okay, I thought she was saying she had quadruplets.
Right,
because
on the screen it said, had 4 kids within 2 hours.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I had 4 kids, and the labor was 2 hours each.
Oh,
you were lucky. Yeah. You were lucky. Yeah. Are you a religious woman?
Yeah. I go to church, and I believe.
All right, good. No, well, then you are. Then you thank God that you had 4 fairly brief labor periods.
Without, like, if you focus on that focal point, they say, and breathe, God is good. A contraction's like 1 minute hard pain and 1 minute to breathe.
Wow, yeah, good for you.
That's okay, but thanks.
Good for you, Terry. I admire you. Thanks that's for the call beautiful. To New Jersey 101.5.
I didn't have long labors either, but why drugs. Be in pain if you don't have to?
Give
be?
Me drugs.
Why?
Linda in Punxsutawney, how did we know we'd have a story
I gave
from Linda?
Naturally from beginning to end. I'm like, sir, you're an idiot.
Hi, Linda.
I guess I'm an idiot, too. I had a midwife and no pain meds, but I don't begrudge anybody their pain meds.
Right. So what happened real quick?
Do it your way.
Tell us.
Real quick, I was pregnant with my second daughter. This was 31 years ago, so ultrasounds were in the dark ages. And I went into labor 6 weeks early. And so they put me on this medicine, and they kept having me go in for ultrasounds because they're waiting for her lungs to be mature. And I had 7 ultrasounds before they said, okay, it's good to go. And every time they told me it was a boy. And so when I delivered her with the midwife had delivered her, my mother-in-law said, it's a girl. My husband said, oh, my God, it's a girl. I don't know. I didn't hear any of them. So they put it up in my chest. The first words I ever said to her, oh, my God, you're a girl.
Aw. I thought you were going to say, oh, my God, your penis fell off.
No.
No, but, you know, in the even today in the ultrasound, like, people will show me the ultrasound. They go, look, see, there's the 2 little whatevers. Or there's the little hamburger they call it for on the girl. And to me, they look exactly this. I still, in this day and age, 2023, can't tell the difference. You can?
Well, I guess they couldn't tell the difference either.
Yeah.
And it was, like I said,
yeah.
So then I wonder how accurate they were with the lungs, because, you know.
Yeah, right. She could have been out 7 weeks before.
All right, Linda, thank you. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. What crazy birth or hospital story do you have? 1-800-283-101.5. It's 11:30. So there was a topic or a story today about these students at Centenary College in New Jersey collecting COVID memorabilia. And I remember telling my son, Greg, I don't know if you're listening, down in North Carolina. I said, one of these days, all this stuff is going to be collectible. Peel off any of those signs that say stay 6 feet apart or must wear a mask, because there were signs everywhere.
I mean, I really should have saved some of that. One day they're going to be worth something.
Yeah, but
somebody on Antiques Roadshow is going to go, there was a big government bureaucrat. His name was Anthony Fauci.
Fauci.
And what happened was it was found out that he was just making up a bunch of rules. One of the rules.
6 feet apart. 6 feet apart.
Not only that, but in those 14 hours of testimony or whatever it was that he gave.
Yeah.
It was basically a 14-hour admission that, like, there was no basis in science for just about anything that happened.
But people worshiped. There were signs on people's lawns, Dr. Fauci, we love you.
Well, forget that. How about the fact that nobody even cares today. Nobody's even like, put this guy in jail
right.
because I lost my business.
Right. All right, so back to the hospital stories. Do you have a birthing story, a crazy story about giving birth, either at the hospital or on the way there or in an elevator on a deserted island? Or do you have a story about something crazy happening at the hospital? 1-800-283-1015 is the phone number. We had three kids, and we had two boys, and we tried for a girl, and it worked. It was reading a book, Selecting the Sex of Your Child by Dr. Shettles. And it worked. We tried the sperm spinning thing first.
Yeah.
And that was like a couple $1,000. I had to do it in a cup and give it to them, and they spun it, and they gave it to her. And they said, it didn't work. And I said, we're done with the spinning. Because, A, I'm not going to the bathroom at work again and doing that. And, B, I don't have another $2,000 to spin my stuff.
Today it would be $50,000.
Yeah.
You're lucky.
So she's like, okay, I found a book. I was like, good. We're doing it by the book. And we had a girl. So this was the third child. She went to the OBGYN for a checkup close to her due date. And the doctor said, you're going to be giving birth today. And she's like, what? You're already, I don't know, how many centimeters dilated? 9, 7, 5, I don't know. So she's called me and said, you got to come over now. I'm going to be giving birth in the next couple hours. The doctor says she's on her way. So I had to take the two boys.
And she didn't even have pains.
No, she was a tough, strong woman. I don't think she had much pain. Like little discomfort.
I'm tough and strong, too.
Anyway, so take the boys to your mom and moms and get over here. So I had a rate. I was doing 70 miles an hour on residential roads, getting over to my parents' house, dropped the boys off and ran over to Philly. And she gave, as soon as I got there, she gave birth.
See, so you have a birth story too.
Yeah, but it was just quick. Like, your wife's in there. How are you doing? How are you feeling? Good. Here's a girl.
But that's a blessing too.
Oh, absolutely.
Did she have the other ones as fast?
Greg came out swinging, came out fast.
Right.
Yeah.
It's always the first one takes so long.
Yeah.
All right, so tell us your amazing birth story. Did you give birth in a cab? Did you almost give birth in your bathtub? 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number. And how'd everything turn out? Or a crazy hospital story that you want to share with us. Bill is in Princeton. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, Dennis and Judy. My eldest son, who is now 40, my youngest son, who is now 40, was born in the hospital. And he was a big, big baby. He was over 12 pounds when they finally weighed him. Being born, his head...
Over 12 pounds born... Fine.
What? 12 that's pounds, yes.
Born.
Yeah.
I didn't even know that was possible. Okay.
Yeah, that's...
Anyway, his head came out, but his shoulders got stuck.
Yeah, I wonder why. Okay.
And the doctor said, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to dislocate one of his shoulders. I said, you're going to do what? He said, I'm going to have to dislocate one of his shoulders to get him out.
In other countries, they'd have to remove his head, so you were lucky.
Right. There are some other countries like that. But anyway, he did it. He dislocated the shoulder, slid him out, and then fortunately, it's not all bone there at the time of birth. There's a lot of cartilage and so forth.
Yeah.
And so fortunately, he got his, after he was born, he got his shoulder back into the right spot. It has never, in the 40 years he's been alive, given him a problem.
Thank God. Is he a broad-shouldered young man?
Yeah, I would say so.
Okay.
And he's always been thin, but his shoulders are broad.
Was he a swimmer? Wow. That sounds like a swimmer. Thin but broad-shouldered.
No, he was not a swimmer.
All right. Very good. Thank you, Bill. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. A couple of years ago, it was during COVID. It was December 2021. I was in the hospital for a couple of days. And the nurse, it was a male nurse. He was really cool. He was one of those people who was taking advantage of visiting nurses, getting paid like triple to go to another hospital.
So yeah, I think I remember this.
Yeah, he was from North Jersey, but he was working in South Jersey because the agency was going to pay him more. So great guy, comes in. And one time I noticed when he came in, he had a full mask on. I said, what's going on? He said, I was visiting the patient next door. So what's going on there? He said, well, I'm not supposed to tell you, but you're on the COVID wing.
I remember
I was on the COVID wing.
Yeah.
He said, relax, you're good. I didn't get COVID.
Then everything started to become the COVID wing because everybody in the hospital had COVID.
Yeah, I didn't have COVID. I wasn't there for COVID. Anyway, do you have a crazy hospital and or giving birth story? 1-800-283-1015 is the phone number. It's 11:44. More of the Dennis and Judi show to come. And a question, do you or a parent find it difficult to step over your bathtub to take a shower? Well, your worries are over. Dennis Malloy here, and I want to tell you about the Tub Cut, which converts your tub into a walk-in shower. Without costly renovation, it's custom fabricated to your needs and completed in just half a day. Even reversible for when you go to sell your home. Just a 4-inch step. No more struggling to get in and out. You avoid serious injuries with improved safety and accessibility. My parents had something like this done, and it was life-changing. Now it's so much more affordable and less intrusive. Call them today, 877-TUB-CUTS, or log on to tubcut.com. Dennis and Judi show talking crazy birth stories or hospital stories. 1-800-283-1015 is the number. Maggie is calling from Union. Hello, Maggie.
Hi, good morning.
Morning.
My good story is my first was born in an hour. My second was born in 2 hours. My third was born in 7 hours. And they had a resident helping out who gave me an episiotomy without any sedation.
Why? Well, wait a minute. Stop. I know tons of people have had episiotomies without sedation because at that moment, you don't feel that.
Because you've got an epidural?
Well, no, because it's... I don't want to get into it, but you don't feel that.
Well, Maggie may have. Maggie did.
Okay. I jumped sky high.
I feel it vicariously, and I'm over here 40 years later.
Yeah, and a lot of blood. A lot of blood.
Okay.
Did we say the no blood rule was in effect, Dennis? No, we did not.
No. And did they stitch you back up?
After they gave me a shot of Novocaine, yeah.
Okay, good. All right. Thank you, Maggie. Appreciate the call. Yeah. That's tough. All right, Joe is calling from Florida, has a hospital story. Good. Hi, Joe.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Good. How are you? What part of Florida?
Right outside of Fort Lauderdale, where it's 82 degrees today.
God bless. How you moved down there, or are you down there for vacation?
No, I moved down here after my crazy hospital story 3 years ago.
Tell us.
I got sick. I was on an airplane coming home from Florida looking for a place to live, and I contracted bronchitis, went to the hospital, went to the doctor. The doctor said, well, there's this new corona something or other. I want you to go right to the emergency room. So I went to the emergency room, and they admitted me, and they came in the next morning. They said, well, we don't think you have the virus, but what you do have is you have a form of pneumonia that's really serious. It's attacked your lungs. We need you to stay here. I said, oh, okay. They said, now understand something. Nobody can come to see you. And once you're here, you're not going to get out of here for a while. So I ended up being locked to this hospital for like 3 weeks.
Oh, my God. Where?
Right at the very beginning in Bryn Mawr Hospital in Philadelphia, outside of Philadelphia.
Right.
So I'm looking out the windows, and there's no traffic there. You know, it's a very busy area. There's nothing. So one night, I guess it was like 2 in the morning, I wake up, and, you know, I'm looking around. You don't hear any noise. And I decide, I probably get this idea, it's like the Twilight Zone, like, I'm the last person alive. Everybody's gone. So I get out of the bed, and I start, like, walking around the hospital, and I don't see anybody. I get to the nurse's station, and there's a half a cup of coffee, and the computer's on, and nobody's there. It's like something out of the Twilight Zone. The next thing I know, Nurse Ratchet comes around the corner screaming at me, what are you doing out of your room? Get back in your room. I'm the only nurse here with 12 patients. Dude, I really thought I was at the end of the world. I thought I was the last living survivor.
And you were 3 weeks in the hospital with bronchitis.
Well, it ended up being pneumonia, which ended up leaving me disabled. It ended up the lung was permanently damaged. It was pretty serious.
Wow.
But, I mean, I didn't get COVID, but I, you know, ended up in the hospital, then went home for a very long rehabilitation period and had to go through all my rehab and all that during COVID, which was very difficult.
How are you now,
by the way?
Now I am living in Florida. I still, COPD has left me a little, I'm on disability. I currently, though, with oxygen, I don't use oxygen all the time, but I currently walk 3 to 4 miles a day using a portable oxygen generator. So, I mean, my quality of life is pretty decent. I couldn't really handle the cold weather anymore.
Right. Well, thank God you're there, and it's 82. Joe, great story. I mean, interesting story, but thank you very much for sharing.
He didn't violate the no-death rule. So
no,
that's good.
Close. A little screaming, but no death.
Mrs. Farkas had a story about twins, but we don't have time, right?
No.
That sucks, Dennis. Well, here's what's good, though. This morning, you woke up in your house warm, toasty. You took it for granted, right? But you have no idea what day you might wake up and all of a sudden your heating is on the fritz. That's why you've got to bring Guaranteed Service into your home. Let them do a heating system tune-up for only $77. Here's what you're buying with that. Peace of mind that you're not going to wake up one day and be freezing in your house. No surprises. And if anything does happen, if anything breaks, you are guaranteed free repair for the entire season. That means no breakdowns for the whole season or the repair is free. That's the guarantee. No questions asked. They stand behind their work and that's why they're called Guaranteed. I love these guys. I've turned so many people onto Guaranteed Service. You'll see the difference in an instant. Go to GuaranteedService.com or call 1-800-GUARANTEED.
Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app, New Jersey. Chime time. 12:10, Dennis and Judy show. I'm Dennis Malloy. That's Judy Franco.
Wow. It just looks like slushy now, Den.
Where are you looking?
I'm saying outside my house, it was so pretty this morning. And now it's just like...
Yeah, it was just outside. Actually, I took a couple pictures. It's a lot of the snow stuck to the trees. Kind of pretty here. Roads are wet, slushy. I think everybody's making it on time. I have an appointment today at 2:30 for somebody to meet me here, and that's still on. So I think today was pretty much everything intact. Schools were closed. Some open
or delayed.
Or delayed. But yeah, we had our friend across the hall, her kids go to school in Hamilton, I think. It was first delayed for 2 hours, and they said, we're done.
Really?
Closed, yeah.
Why? You think they just looked around and said, this is too hard?
Well, it was going to continue through the rush hour. And then, so you not only had the problem of driving in rush hour, but then when it would end around 1 or 2 in this area.
Right.
It would freeze. The temperatures are going to drop. So they were worried about, you know, especially kids, seniors driving in this stuff. Anyway.
Okay.
It is snowy and pretty in some areas. And it's winter time, and there's not a whole lot to do if you're not an outdoor sportsman or not a skier or hunter. There's not a whole lot to do in the winter. It's nice to find a cozy restaurant.
Yes.
We need your help.
I have to ask you a question, though, because one of the ones that has come up in the past and always comes up this time of year when we talk about this.
Really?
Yeah. And
I don't remember talking about it. Cozy restaurants?
Yeah, we've talked about this before.
Oh, okay.
Den, you'd be hard-pressed to find something we have not talked
about. I know, but
before.
I don't specifically remember cozy restaurants.
Okay, well, this is what comes up all the time when we talk about cozy restaurants. Romantic restaurants, cozy restaurants, restaurants with a fire, but we've done it a million different ways.
Okay.
Peapack and Gladstone.
Mm-hmm.
The Gladstone Tavern. Explain. Peapack and Gladstone. Explain.
How do I know?
You're a Jersey guy.
I know, but it's in the
Somebody's
same area.
Somebody's going to have to explain it to me. Are they twins? Are they fighting? Are they sister cities? What are they? Why can they never be separated? You know? It's like...
A precipitous Troy
I'm
Hills.
I'm from Turks and Caicos.
Yeah.
You know, I'm from Trinidad and Tobago.
How about like, Parsippany Troy Hills?
Yeah, exactly. Good point.
How about Efim?
Although I've heard Parsippany used without Troy Hills.
Yeah. Well,
P-Pat,
how about...
P-Pat Gladstone is like one word.
Well, like Marlton and Evesham?
No, not the same at all.
Why not? I don't know. Because how do you know? You P-Pat, just asked. You just said you don't know what they are.
Because I've heard Marlton 1,000 times, and I've heard people say Evesham 1,000 times.
Right.
I've never heard anybody say, oh, I live in P-Pat. They go, P-Pat Gladstone.
Is that the question for the hour?
The high school is called P-Pat Gladstone High School.
So is Parsippany Troy Hills.
Really?
Right. Is that the question this hour?
No.
Okay.
Then the question is...
Tell us about a cozy restaurant in your corner of New Jersey. 1-800-283-1015. I don't know. I guess it's open this time of year. The Windlass... On Lake Hopatcong, I went there in the late spring, early summer.
Do I know this from you, or do I know it because it comes up?
From me. And then people, I was apparently not pronouncing it correctly, because it's spelled W-I-N-D-L-A-S-S, so I was saying Windlass.
Oh, I was saying
it's the Windlass.
Windlass.
Right, but it's the Windlass. It's a piece of equipment on a boat.
Well, don't spell it that way. Jesus.
It's great. It's on Lake Hopatcong, and there, above it, there's another one. I think it's owned by the same people, just above it, with a woman's name.
Do you mean when you say cozy?
Then? All right, see, the Windlass is cozy because it's on the lake, and it's kind of got a cozy interior. Now, the one by me in Evesham, or Marlton, that I go to occasionally... And it's just cozy any time of the year. And that's Redstone.
Let me tell you it's what my dark. Problem is with this.
Yeah.
Cozy usually connotes something small.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
No, the Windlass isn't small and neither is
that's
Redstone.
That's why I don't think we can, that's why I don't think you can
call it cozy
in there. Like, you know, in real estate, whenever they say a house is cozy,
that's not the same. That's not the same.
Huh.
See, now, the Redstone is cozy because it's dark and it's got compartments. It's like got bar booths around the bar, and then on the outside of those booths are more booths on the other side, which face more booths near the window. And then there's tables on the other side. And then there's an area that's sort of outside enclosed with tables.
Okay, so you think that's cozy because...
Because of the booths and the lighting.
Lighting does make something romantic. But let's give the phone number. 1-800-283-101.5. We actually want to put a post together. So we really need your help and your participation in this hour. Here's what you do. What is the coziest New Jersey restaurant you could think of? 1-800-283-101.5. We're talking cozy. Windlass is closed till the end of January for renovations.
Oh, okay.
Pete
Torriello?
Uh-huh.
All right. Thank you, Pete.
Well, it's good he said that because now people are like, oh, Dennis from the radio likes this. Let's drive out there and go there.
So if you like the Windlass, it's a great restaurant any time of year, but it's closed till the end of January for renovations. Okay. So for me, the Redstone in Marlton, very cozy. Okay. There's a winery. A lot of cozy wineries. Now, you can include wineries in this, too.
Okay.
Horses are not welcome?
You could also include your favorite grilled cheese sandwich.
No, because you're such a jerk. It's not. Most of these wineries... offer food.
Also, your favorite elementary school sport. Four square table.
Why are you being a D and you don't even have one?
I know, Mark always calls me D-less.
Anyway.
But can I just say one thing?
Because wineries, people go there to dine too, and it's or
they
drink.
Do?
Or, yeah, and both.
See, I don't know because I don't go to wineries.
Well, because you're a D. And they're
D-less.
Some very cozy one. Now, the one I go to on occasion is...
it's like windless.
Exactly.
I'm D-less.
Sharrett. I call it Sharrett, but they pronounce it Sharrett. Sharrett Winery in Hamilton. High ceilings, all wood, but cozy because just the way they have it, just a cozy, they built it a few years ago. It's beautiful, like a barn, but it's cozy, and they have music on Saturday and Sunday afternoons, and the food's good, and there's, you know.
Okay, I just thought of the quintessential cozy place.
All right, tell me.
I want to see if you agree with me.
All right.
Tara's Tavern.
Yes, cozy. No, not
right?
Yes, cozy.
Also, there are a lot of Italian restaurants, but they're not all cozy. I'll tell you what's cozy. Because of just what you said, lighting, decor, boothiness.
Okay.
Boothiness is a factor.
Boothiness, okay.
Vic's.
Okay.
I can name you 10 Italian restaurants that are not cozy. That one's cozy.
How about Federici's in Freehold?
Also cozy.
Right?
Also very cozy. Yeah.
Now, you wouldn't say romantic, but you'd say cozy.
Correct.
Okay. So tell us about
Well, now that we're going by your definition of cozy.
Oh, now that I feel like I just had open heart surgery.
I'm serious.
Yeah, me too. All right, 1-800.
It's different than like cozy, meaning like one, Little Italy, 20 by
right.
100.
Doesn't have to be small, but cozy New Jersey restaurants, bars, wineries. 1-800.
You know when you're like really close to the other tables?
Yes.
That type of cozy.
1-800-283-101.5 is the phone number. 1220. Pete, do you go to the Windlass often?
No, I just looked it up because I heard you talking about it. And I said, gee, that sounds like a place that I would enjoy. And I like Lake Hopatcong a lot.
Yeah.
And then it came up on their website that they're closed to the end of the month for renovations.
Well, there's a place above it that's owned by the same owners. It's a woman's name. I have to look it up.
Is that the one on Route 15?
No, I don't think so, because it's on the same property, basically, as Windlass. Okay. And that's just above it. So you have a beautiful view of the lake. And that's probably still open. I'll check to see if that one's open.
Yeah.
All right, 1220, time for New Jersey Faster. So it's wintertime in New Jersey, and New Jersey has a ton of cool restaurants to choose from. Every different variety of ethnicity and food type. But we're looking for cozy places this time of year. Could be a bar, restaurant, winery. Give me cozy. I tell you, a cozy place, but you certainly wouldn't go there for fine dining. Or maybe even for a date, but I went there for lunch with my daughter. I loved it. Gyps Tavern. Small, cozy, on the lake. Small. It's not much of a place, but I love that place. So give us an idea. So it could be elegant, cozy, beautiful, cozy, warm, cozy, small, cozy New Jersey restaurants. Scott in Jackson. Hi, Scott.
How's it going, guys?
Good. How are you?
Good, thank you. You ever go to a Huddy's?
What is it?
Huddy's?
No.
In Colsack?
No. Judy, have you heard of Huddy's?
Never heard of it in my life. Is it DDY or TTY?
I'm not too sure, but it's HU. It starts HUDD, I believe. Yeah.
Okay.
Bro, you guys never heard of it?
No. And Judy, that's your neighborhood. No.
That's been there. It's across from the Cold Snack Hotel on the corner of 537 and 34 there.
All right. What kind of food?
Okay.
Like meatloaf, you know, Mexican food.
And what makes it cozy? Is it dark inside, a low ceiling? What?
It's dark. It's all brick fireplace.
Oh, nice.
You know, really nice. The bar's separate from it. So you have the restaurant and then you have the bar. They have an outside section. I can't believe you guys have never been there. They've been around 30, 40 years. They were across the street originally, and then they moved here and built this structure. But really a nice place. Reasonable, too.
I mean, it wouldn't make sense for Dennis to have ever been there because he's so far. But I guess, yeah, that may be one town, Dennis, where that I've never dined in. Cold snack.
Cold snack. All right, Scott, thank you very much. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. AJ is calling from Vineland. Hi, AJ.
Hey, guys. I love your show. I just want to say that I don't... you guys ever heard of the Claridge Hotel in Atlantic City?
Of course.
Yes.
Yeah.
There's a rooftop bar called The View.
View. V-U.
The V-U-E.
V-U-E, right.
The View Bar. And let me tell you something. You take the elevator to the top floor. It's like an old-style type of, bar. And then they have the wraparound porch that you can actually go outside in when it's nice weather and just look at the city from the rooftop.
All right. I've seen that advertised, and I've seen it listed, and I thought, I got to go there. What floor is it? Is it way up high?
On the 23rd floor.
Okay. Very good.
And the staff over there are so nice. They are like the nicest people in Atlantic City. And, I mean, you go in there, you feel like your family. So that's what I love about it.
And it's a good restaurant? Like, you can sit and have a nice meal there?
It's more like just like a bar lounge. I mean, you know.
But you can get something to eat. You can get something to eat.
Yeah. All right, we'll include it.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Very good. Thank you. Appreciate
the
call.
Remember what you were including before, Dennis?
What's that?
You were including anything. Oh, wineries.
Because at most wineries, they serve food.
But I didn't realize you could
because
eat a winery,
because you're a
okay?
gay.
All right. Again, shaming me for my mental health issues? Not a great thing to do in 2023, Dennis. Read the room.
Read the room, Judy.
Do better.
Read the room.
Hashtag do better. Do
better. We're better than that, Judy. All right. 12:30. The phone number is 1-800-283-1015. Talking about cozy restaurants in New Jersey that we may not have heard of. It's 12:30. We're talking cozy places to check out this winter in New Jersey. Wineries, restaurants, bar. I guess I threw Gyps Tavern in there. I think that's cozy. I got two in Atlantic City that are cozy, but we'll talk to Diane and Cinnaminson first. Hi, Diane. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. We have a nice little place in Cinnaminson called Duamici's. D-U-E-A-I-M-C-I. They're really nice. It's a small little place. The chef is the owner. And you can, if you have something special, you can dress up. If you don't, you can dress down. In the summertime, you can sit outside. They have a little pond out there, but it's also very nice in the winter. And it's a BYOB.
That's where our family had the repast for when my dad passed away about 4 years ago. We had the lunch in there. It was very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Due Amici. Very good. Thank you for that, Diane.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
You too. I almost forgot about that place. Still around. What cozy places can you recommend in New Jersey for, a place to get out on Saturday or Sunday? 1-800-283-101.5. Two in Atlantic City, Judy. One is a dinner place, and it's not fancy, but it's cozy.
Okay.
Brick walls, and it's... Scaniccio's at Lefty's Bar.
You lost me. How do you spell it?
S-C-H-A-N-N-I-C-H-I-O.
Okay.
Scaniccio's.
Where did you even find this place? Yeah.
I don't remember how I found it.
Okay.
But it's kind of in my neighborhood. It's if you go to the Trop and go toward the bay about 3-4 blocks.
Yeah.
It's in that neighborhood.
Okay.
Another one further south in, I guess it would be in the lower Chelsea neighborhood. It's a breakfast and lunch place. And the reason it's cozy is because it's tiny.
Tiny makes it.
If you're heavy, if you're a large person, you can't go to the bathroom there.
Remember that place we went to in Haddon Field?
Haddon Heights.
Haddon Heights, right, not Haddonfield.
It's like the Station Inn or something.
And it was adorable. It was like in an old house or whatever, but it also had one of those bathrooms where, like, you had a diet to get into. Remember?
Yeah,
no,
yeah, this, I think, is even smaller. If you're heavy or large, you can't go to the bathroom there.
Just don't go. Just hold it in.
Run to the drop, which I think is the closest casino. 1-800-283-101.5. Just checking the... the Pluckerman Inn in Bedminster. Very cozy, charming, elegant. That's from Mimi. There are blazing fireplaces. There are two barrel ceiling rooms downstairs for small parties.
Wow.
Verona Italian Restaurant in Randolph. Super cozy. They have fantastic food, and you have to make a reservation because they are booked every night. The Verona Italian Restaurant in Randolph. That's from Steph. And Mitch says, Dennis Windlass, great place to ice fish. Have someone drill your hole, set up your bait line, sit at the bar and look out at the window and wait for the flag to pop up, and you have a fish.
But what's the fun of that?
Have someone drill your hole and set up your... I guess people will do that for you? I just figured you're ice fishing, you got to do all that yourself.
Not only that, but like, then what's the fun of it? You could also go to the supermarket and buy a fish.
Yeah, but you're sitting at the bar having a drink, getting schnockered.
But then you're not fishing, is the point I'm trying to make.
Says you.
Again, Dennis. Mocking me.
What? Your brand of fishing may not be the same as another.
Mocking me, I don't know.
All right, let's go to Marilyn in Mendham. Hi, Marilyn.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. I'm driving on really scary roads. But anyway, I love the Riverview Mill Inn on the river in Clinton, New Jersey.
Hmm. Okay. Riverview Mill Inn.
Clinton. Yeah, it's had many names over the years. I think it was the Muddy Minnow at one point. But it literally...
That was Judy's nickname.
It wasn't.
What?
That was Judy's
Stop
nickname.
I'm an idiot.
Camp. That was Judy's nickname at camp back she was 11.
Actually, I just have to say something. I've called in like a number of times, I think, as you know. Judy, we were in the same play together a million years ago in Summit, New Jersey, when you played Fanny Bryce in Funny Girl. Hello?
What? Yeah. Well, she's...
No, I'm sorry. I'm trying to figure out ever being in a play in Summit.
Oh, okay. All right. My cousin Vinny told me you were in Funny Girl in the Metropolitan Musical Theater in Summit?
Yeah, no, that never happened.
Oh, great. Okay, maybe it's another Judy. All right, sorry.
No, but back in school, they always referred to her as that funny girl.
They did. No, that's funny because, you know, I have actually played that part, but I played it in Brooklyn, nowhere near New Jersey. But
interesting.
Tell your cousin Vinny, he's an idiot.
Sorry.
Well, great conversation. Thank you for that, Mary Lynn.
Take care.
You too.
Love
Appreciate
you.
The call.
She better call up Vinny now and be like, you made me make a fool of myself. No, Summit, no. And I've been in tons of plays, but Summit was not one of my places. Jeannie is in Beechwood. Hi, Jeannie. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hello. How are you?
Good. How are you?
We're doing good.
Very well. We're snowed in, kind of. Nice to be snowed in.
Well, Beechwood got like slushy stuff, right? You didn't get a whole lot.
Yeah, no, we didn't get a lot, but it's nice because the kids, like, we played hooky today.
Cool.
So we were like, oh, it's a snow day because there's no more snow days anymore, you know?
Right. So what'd you do? What's the restaurant?
Scarborough Fair.
Where's that?
This sounds familiar. I feel like I've seen it.
Oh,
where is it?
It's in Seagirt.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's in Seagirt. It is the most beautiful. They decorate their restaurant to be like, at Christmas time, they put up the most beautiful lights.
Valentine's Day. They put up like the most incredible decorations.
You're reminding me that my crazy friend, his bar, the Ark in Point Pleasant.
Oh, love the Ark. Yeah. I used to live right near there.
And that place is cozy.
Very cozy.
Ark, I'm glad you brought that up, Dennis.
And because you were describing at Seagirt at the Scarborough Fair, the way they decorate the holidays, they do the same at the Ark where it's cozy and they decorate. Very good. Jeannie, very good.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Thanks. Have a great day. Enjoy the kids in the snow and your cheat day, hooky day, snow day. All right, Judy, listen, when you are ready to sell your home fast, you need to call Robert Dukansky of RE/MAX First Advantage. Jose and Hilda missed their grandchildren, so they decided to sell their home in Avenel to move closer to them. Rob Dukansky was the real estate agent for that job. After 16 showings and only 9 days on the market, the property sold for $450,000, which was $330,100 over the list price.
Nothing beats Rob's Your Home Sold Guaranteed program. You really don't need to worry about things like interest rates or market uncertainty when you choose the right agent. Find out more at robsellsnj.com. Now, Rob Dukansky doesn't just list your home, but he has the in-house marketing to drive hundreds of buyers to your home, creating demand and driving up the price. You need to call the only agent we would call if we needed to sell our homes. Who is it, Den?
That would be Rob Dukansky, 855-350-1015. That's 855-350-1015. Or go online, robsellsnj.com. That's robsellsnj.com. Or just Google Rob Sells NJ and then
start back. Time.
It's the Dennis and Judy Show. And we're talking about cozy places to go in the winter in New Jersey. You go out, get out of the house, just go get something to eat. You don't want to go to a local diner. You want an atmosphere that's like, oh, I really enjoyed that. That was nice. Makes you feel, you know, special, different, cozy. You know?
Don't I know? I'm the queen of cozy den.
Along with, as well as the Muddy Minnow was your other nickname.
By the way, you know how I feel, Dennis, about nautically named restaurants?
Like the Rusty Scupper?
Yeah, and I'm always like, don't think it sounds appetizing to go to a place called the Rusty Scupper.
Or the Muddy Minnow.
Or the Barnacle Bills. Or the, what's the other one?
Muddy Minnow.
The Gunky Guppy, you know?
It's the like sludge, what? The Sludgy Bilge Pump. We're going to the Sludgy Bilge Pump. Would you want to come? Sure.
Why do people, the scummy, scampy? Why? And why? Why don't they realize that it's an unattractive? Unless maybe that's part of the allure of eating seafood out, where like you want to just like smell bad stuff.
Let's go to the Scuzzy Clam Bucket. Okay. Why?
Right or not?
Yeah, I know. All right, Linda's like, calling.
And God bless it. It should have 120 years of wonderful success. The very, very popular restaurant, Barnacle Bill's, which I think is still open.
The Rusty Scupper was one in Princeton, was one in Cherry Hill. And then the menu was on a paddle.
And it's rusty. Oar. Like, rust should not be anywhere near the name of a restaurant. Same thing with Barnacle. Isn't the barnacles, the stuff that's like stuck on the bottom of the boat and you have to scrape it off?
Yeah.
So explain.
Linda is in Medford Lakes. Hi, Linda.
Hi. You're right, Judy. Anyway, in our area, Dennis, Il Villaggio.
Now, I got an email from Nextdoor app yesterday and I opened it up. I'll never go to that place. Overpriced food and lousy
what
service. And Il Villaggio. In, what's that, Cherry Hill?
Yeah, on Berlin Road. They have a bar now. I didn't even know that. They just did that about 3 months ago, I guess. I just heard.
Well, they said it was overpriced and the food was average. What do you think?
Well, I don't know. I mean, the food is really good. It's great quality. They have a nice fireplace. You know, it used to be Nana. You know, it's a cozy place. It's nice.
Cherry Hill. Yeah, I hate when people trash restaurants and they go, oh, it's overpriced. What do you... A critic for the New York Times? I mean, just some schlub who lives in Leisure Town, who took a ride to Cherry Hill, and you're trashing some family's business, and the prices are too high. Well, the price of, I mean, yeah, eating out lately is ridiculous because the price of everything is through the roof.
Right. Well, the other thing would be Braddock's Tavern.
Oh, yes. Why didn't I think of that?
Yeah. And, you know, and upstairs they have a fireplace. They don't use the one downstairs now, but it's still very cozy. The bar's great, you know.
I love the bar. And they have a fireplace upstairs. They have brunch on Sundays.
Yep.
Very good. Thank you, Linda. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. I got Jim and Glenn Gardner. Jim, real quick, what do you got?
How's it going, man?
Good.
It's not too much snow up here. We're up in the Glenn Gardner area.
What's it called?
Maybe about 1.5 inches.
Wow.
But, the restaurant,
it's called the Pub House?
The restaurant in Hope, New Jersey. It's called the Pump House.
All right, very good. Thank you, Jim. We're having a little trouble with your line. That was weird, wasn't it?
Yeah. Some sort of interference there. We'll get back to him. Right now, let's take... Mikey?
The pup. No, we got to run.
Oh, shoot. What?
You want to take Mikey? Real quick, take Mikey.
He was going to talk about your winery.
Yes, go Mikey.
Go Mikey.
Hey, Judy. Dennis. Hey, Happy New Year to you.
Thank you. Same to you, Mikey. What do you have?
God bless. The Valentine Winery. Really fantastic there.
Oh, yeah. Friends of mine.
They got good food, the red wine, everything. People are really, really nice there.
They really are. Very good. And Chemung Valenzano. Thank you, Mikey. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Listen, do you or a parent find it difficult to step over your bathtub to take a shower? Well, your worries are over. Dennis Malloy here, and I want to tell you about the Tub Cut, which converts your tub into a walk-in shower with no costly renovation, custom fabricated to meet your needs, completed in just half a day. It's even reversible for when you go to sell your home. Just a 4-inch step, no more struggling to get in and out. You avoid serious injuries with improved safety and accessibility. My parents had something like this done a few years back. It was life-changing. Now it's far less expensive and less intrusive with this. Call 877-TUB-CUTS. Or log on to tubcut.com. Parks Casino and Sportsbook, New Jersey. Chime time is 109. It's Dennis and Judy Show. I'm Dennis Malloy. That's Judy Franco.
Is there a more fun place to be at this radio station than the Dennis and Judy Show studios?
No.
True.
So, your girl, Taylor Swift.
She ain't my girl.
No.
She's far from my girl anymore.
She was my girl, but.
Yeah, well, she had to go to the.
Dark side.
Yeah.
You have to. If you're in that business, and you have to. Makes life easier, certainly more profitable. You're not going to lose any money.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, so. She gave her scarf to a fan at the Chiefs game on Saturday. It was cold, apparently, in Kansas City. It was one of the coldest days of the year. Wherever they were playing was in Kansas City, I guess, yeah. So she gave her her scarf. And, of course, the scarf probably, if she sold it online, would bring hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Right, but she won't because if she's a fan, she wants it for herself, right?
And she said it smells like home. The scarf.
Oh, my God. Okay. All right. So the question, of course, is, do you own anything? Any, memorabilia from a famous person?
Yeah, celebrity memorabilia.
Or is it just, historic? Like, any valuable memorabilia?
Yeah, what do you have, collect, come across, been given, gifted, of value? Something you collect. Any memory?
I don't know if it's a value. Doesn't have to be a value.
Okay, all right, but it's
right?
It's a value to you. That's why you collect it.
So I have a signed Peter Max poster. I think you do too.
Wow.
Didn't we get these together?
I think we did. I had something in my memory.
Some event we did. Somebody gave it to us.
Peter Max is?
Oh, he was an artist back in the 70s. He did all those. The minute I show it to you, you're going to know who he is.
Okay.
Very groovy work. Peter Max. He's still alive. German Jewish guy. This is his, as a matter of fact, this is what I have signed. That's so funny. This flag with my heart.
Oh.
I have that. It's a poster. I mean, okay. It's not like the original. Right. But anyway, that's what his art looks like.
Yeah, yeah.
He used to be on the cover of, this was one of the famous ones. He used to be on the on album covers.
Yeah.
And, you know, he was very groovy.
Yeah, it was groovy art is how I would categorize that. So do you have any kind of memorabilia, a collectible, do you collect anything, either from a celebrity, show business, tickets to, I had 5 tickets to a hockey game. It was Mario Lemieux's last game.
Really? Did you?
Yep. You know why I say he did?
Why?
Came out of retirement and played another season.
Oh, dumbbell. Why do you do that?
Mario!
Why do you do that?
I was like, I'm hanging on to this. It was like, that was it. I think we eliminated in the playoffs, and that was it. And I was like, you know, one of my sons said, those are going to be valuable. Hang on. I've had him in my sock drawer for years, Judy.
That's so funny.
Or 1 year, then the next year he came out of retirement. So so this woman was at the Chiefs game. Taylor Swift saw that she was cold. She was in, I guess, a box, an enclosed, and they opened the window, and she reached out and gave the scarf to the woman.
That's cute. That's very nice.
So what is it you collect, have a collection of, maybe got famous memorabilia of some kind? 1-800-283-1015 is the phone number. What's the matter?
Nothing. I'm just looking to see, like, about Peter Max. Like, if you wanted to buy one of his paintings now.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I don't have a painting. I have a signed poster. But you know something's expensive when you click on his fine art and it says, please call to inquire.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So what do you think it goes for, though? Something like that, like a modern artist who's still alive, like he, but very famous.
I would have no idea.
Me neither. No, I'm like, clue. Is it 25,000? Is it 25 million? I don't know. All right. So anyway, the phone number is 1-800-283-101.5. Do you own anything that is some sort of memorabilia? Like, I have Bruce Springsteen's prescription bottle. And
you went rooting through his trash.
I went rooting through his trash, yeah, when I was younger.
And he lived in Freehold or what?
Colts Neck.
Colts Neck.
Yeah, and he lives in Colts Neck now. I'm sorry. Was it Homedale? Mm. Telegraph Hill. That was Homedale. Homedale.
Okay.
Lived in Homedale. And in his backyard, he had like one of these raised houses. And could pull right into his driveway at the time because it was way before, you know, he was. This is, I'm talking about, I'm not going to say the year because it's going to make me sound
like a crazy little stalker girl.
Crazy little stalker girl. And we went, there's garbage. And we found prescription bottle of cough medicine with his name on it. His Life magazine with the subscription label on it. And we got a bunch of personal photos. That was great. I think I posted one a couple of years ago on our website here of him just fooling around in his living room with his friends and stuff like that. So I don't know that any of that would ever be worth anything, but memorabilia it is nonetheless. 1-800-283-101.5 is our number.
One of the other questions I had on the sheet today was, if you could trade places with anyone, who would you trade places with? I think for both of us, it would be like, no, thank you. But if there is a person, first thing I thought was Travis Kelce. Tall, good-looking, athlete, wealthy, dating Taylor Swift.
Right, you mean just from the outside of
it? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, there's a bunch of people just from the outside.
So,
but I know that once I get involved in their lives, I just want mine back again.
That's what I thought. I thought, all right, I'm Travis Kelce. I'm at the end of my career. I had a bad season. I'm on all these soup commercials with my brother and my mom. I'm dating T-Swift. And then I'm thinking, she's written a ton of songs about guys she dumped over after a couple of years. It always ends tragically.
Right.
She's probably,
or maybe they dump her.
Yeah. Is she a high maintenance pain? Then I'm thinking, I'm good. I'm fine being a short little Italian guy.
Yeah, now, but I have to tell you, like I always say, you know, my husband's family had all this money when I married him, and then they didn't, you know? And I always say, like, thank God I didn't marry him for, well, I mean, I did marry him for his money, but thank God I fell in love with him anyway, you know?
Right.
But this time, if it's something, this time, at this age of my life, if anything happened and I was looking, God forbid a million times, 1,000% money, money, money. Wow. That's what I would do. Because it's not like I'm looking to be in love. I'm not going to ever like somebody the way I like Mark.
Right.
So just find me like a rich guy. He'll spend money on me. I'll make him dinner a couple times.
Travis Kelce. All right, before we go to traffic, let's get Virginia
in. Why did we bring that up? Oh, because you were going to ask who would you trade places
with. Yeah, and maybe we can ask that as a secondary question. We can ask people who they trade places with. Virginia in Jackson, hi. TV stars' autographs. Okay. One thing Virginia does not have, that's good phone etiquette.
Oh, you're right, because she'll cough right into the phone.
Well, Kyle used to tell them, please turn down your radio and listen on the phone. He probably still does.
Yeah,
all right,
means,
Virginia, hold on. We'll
TV.
Talk to you after the... What's that?
That may be the TV in the background. I don't know that.
I thought it was us.
I didn't hear myself. Car. Put it back on. Put that back
now,
on.
Who do you think coughs real loud?
Okay. Let me hear
I'm kidding.
This.
No, we got to go to traffic. Virginia, Frank, Harry, hang on. What memorabilia do you have or collect or collectibles do you have? 1-800-283-1015. No, I'm not collecting memorabilia, celebrity stuff, which is stuff that you find valuable or precious to you. A woman was given a scarf by Taylor Swift over the weekend at a football game, and she'll treasure it for life. Says it smells like home. Probably means it smells like a closet. Judy on the app chat, a guy named Jumbo Jet Pilot, got the Joe Cocker's car. Joe Cocker, he only had one car his entire life. He died. When he died, this guy's parents bought it from his estate.
Nuh-uh.
This Jaguar was British rock singer Joe Cocker's only car, owned by him from 1995 until his death in 2014. He learned to drive in it. It is, as purchased, a 95... XL, V12, blah, blah, blah. 78,000 new. And it was for auction. This guy also has, and so I have the picture of it here. He also has Joe Cocker's glasses.
How? How does he have all
this
stuff?
He got it in this auction from his estate.
That's amazing. That's so cool.
My favorite was John Belushi impersonating him on Saturday Night Live. You remember?
Of course.
Whoa, what you spastic, crazy. All right, Harry is in Howell. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Hi, Harry.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
I have an autographed first edition of Wanda Hickey's Night of Golden Memories by Gene Shepard.
Gene Shepard was a New York radio personality and author.
Yes.
Yes.
He's a radio god. Most people know him today from A Christmas Story.
Right.
With Ralphie, You'll Shoot Your Eye Out Kid.
Right. He's the one that narrates it.
Right. And I spent a good part of my youth listening to him on a transistor radio on WOR. And he announced that his new book was coming out, and he would be at Monmouth Shopping Center. This is before it was Monmouth Mall, at Bamberger's. And I had my mom take me there. I was in fifth grade, and I went to the book department, and, you know, he did a little routine. And then we all lined up to get our autographed copies of the book. And, you know, he wrote to Harry, Flick Lives, Gene Shepard, and I still have this book. It's worth some money because it's a first edition autograph, but I'll never part with it.
I'm still trying to get over the fact that there was a book department at Bamberger's.
Well, they used to have a lot of departments. They used to have, you know, a hi-fi department and all that stuff.
That's awesome. Harry, thank you. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5.
Not going to lie. I'm not as old as Harry, but I do remember when it was Mama's Shopping Center, and I do remember Bamberger.
All right, his generation, people collected things, got autographs, treasured things signed by people. Do younger people today have that same
interest?
Why not?
I don't know. We've talked about this before. There isn't that interest in nostalgia. There isn't that interest in...
What about the Comic-Con people and the gamer people?
Oh, yeah, they collect stuff.
All right, there you go.
But
they do.
It's not like they collect... Like, my son has, you know, a bunch of video games. I don't think he cares if they're autographed by anybody. But I think also, Dennis, because the emergence of social media has made everything so now-centric that you don't have time to look forward or look back.
Interesting.
It's just now.
That's a good point, but I think they're the gamers and the Comic-Con people and people who are into that kind of stuff would collect stuff.
Collect?
Yeah.
Yes, but you're talking about having a reverence for a particular item because it reminds you of somebody or something or somebody signed something and there's value in that. No.
There's no
memories son's collection. Yeah, trust me.
I like what you said about social media making just...
Don't you think? Well, there's no time.
All right, let's try to get a couple calls in before the news break. Dana is in the state somewhere. Hi, Dana.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. I have a little piece of Peter Mack's art, so I thought I would share that. It was handed down from my dad, and... he actually went to school with him and ran into him in New York City. And I'm not sure if it was grammar school or high school, but they recognized each other. And Peter Mack did a little sketch on a napkin for my dad and even put his phone number on it with his signature. So my dad framed it and had it for a while, and then it was handed down to me.
Wow, that's going to be worth something, Dana. You know that.
Yeah. It's tiny, you know, it's a napkin size, but... it's pretty cool.
Doesn't matter. He drew it, you know?
Did you ever call the number?
No, actually, I didn't.
That'd be so funny. Like, Peter, hi. I don't know. My father gave me a number when I'm hanging out.
All right, Dana, great call. Thank you. Appreciate the call.
I was thinking, like, I'm going to go to the Starbucks on Route 35. You want to meet, have, like, a coffee, whatever.
Do you think Jen has any memorabilia?
Oh, for sure. Her dad was a professional baseball player.
That's true. He was. Yes. I actually have memorabilia from you guys.
What?
No. She also has Springsteen stuff. Are you
kidding? I have a lot of stuff, yeah. Yeah,
somebody on the app chat said they have a signed Dennis and Judy picture and they're waiting for it to accumulate in value.
Oh, that's
good.
And
retire.
Like, yeah, that's going to happen.
You're going to be very old.
Yeah, I was going to say. No, I'm kidding, guys.
All right. So you got a lot of Springsteen stuff.
I do have Springsteen stuff. I do have a baseball card for my dad. My mom has that. Yeah, we have a bunch of stuff from him, yeah. That's we have his uniform. Mm-hmm.
We're talking about memorabilia, stuff you collect. What is it you have? 1-800-283-101.5. It's 1:30.
Now the latest...
It's Dennis and Judy show, 1:36. We're talking about collecting stuff. Stuff you have that's a treasure, either financially or just it means a lot to you. What is it you've collected over the years? 1-800-283-101.5. Taylor Swift gave her scarf to a woman at a Chiefs game over the weekend. It was very, very cold. I'm sure that would be worth hundreds of thousands. She says it smells like home.
You really think that much, then?
Anything associated with Taylor Swift these days? Gold.
It's really true.
And who would you trade places with if you could? And I said... Travis Kelce, because he's with Taylor.
Right. Every guy would want to trade places with anybody with Taylor.
Right. For a week.
I get it. Right. And then after that, your mom can have her back or whoever has her.
Greg Gutfeld.
Oh, yeah, I can see that. Me too, probably.
Yeah. All right. For about a week. Like I said, like you said earlier, we both said you'd want to trade back after a little bit. You go, oh, that's for cool. Sure. It's fun. Give me the old Dennis, the old Judy back. All right. 1-800-283-101.5. We have so much to be thankful for, and We appreciate it. Paul is in Stewartsville. See what Paul's got. A bunch of baseball stuff. Hey, Paul.
Hey, how are you doing, sir? How's everything?
Everything's good. So what do you have?
Good, good. Well, here's the deal. I work in the hospitality business, okay? So I run into a lot of people. When I was living up in Boston, I knew I was going to meet Ted Williams. So I had a picture of him. I think it was a 1942 opening day. Yeah, and he autographed it. But I always had them personalize it because it just, it's for me. I'm never going to sell it or anything else.
Well, Paul, that's nice. And that's, you know, I'm sure the person appreciates that as well. Was he nice to you?
He's a little high strung, but who am I? You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're a human being, and he's a human being, and yeah. Which means he should be at least cordial. He was the most amazing baseball player ever, and a very interesting human being.
Why?
Yeah, extremely intense. Yeah.
Gave up.
He just had a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, he had a lot of stuff going on, but he gave up big chunks of his career to serve in World War II as like a fighter pilot or
Korea.
Something.
And Korea.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yep.
And being the best baseball player in the world, you think today's athletes are doing that?
No.
Please.
No, not at all. And when he had the opportunity to, you know, sit down to keep the 400 average, he said, no, play me. And then he went out and he hit the ball again.
Amazing. Amazing guy.
Yeah.
But I'm sure he was a little tight, I'm sure.
Yeah. He that's a nice way of saying it. The pen skipped. He goes, oh, just, I'm not going to even say it, pen.
Right.
Like, yes, sir, you're right.
Yeah, very good.
Freaking pen.
All right, thank you, Paul. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Judy, we have somebody on the line who's 23 who collects
them. Okay, good, because we have, Dennis and I have this argument. I don't think young people collect things.
We disagree on this item, Judy.
You know what? Write that down, Dennis, because there's very few things we disagree about.
Nicholas, hi.
How's it going, Dennis?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. I got a Derek Jeter signed baseball. He signed it for my dad, who's a chef in Florida. Made a mean Cuban sandwich, and it was so good that he signed a ball for my dad. Now it's mine.
How long ago?
Probably like 7 years ago or so.
Were you a big Derek Jeter fan when you were little?
Huge fan. Still a huge fan.
Yeah. And he does a lot of commercials now. He's doing a lot of commercial work.
Yeah, a little.
Very good. All right, Nicholas, thank you. If you are a retired African-American athlete, get an agent. They don't even have to get an agent. They'll tackle you walking down the street and say, can you do a commercial?
White athletes don't do that?
They do, but it seems...
Not as much.
Charles Barkley, Shaq.
Oh, Shaq is ridiculous. Shaq was like at the end of my driveway trying to sell me something this morning.
I saw him last night on a Duna. Was it a commercial for Cruise Line? Carnival Cruise?
Oh.
He's sitting
I didn't
on the
even see that
yeah,
one.
That's a new one. He does printers, cruises,
everything,
whatever. And Charles Barkley with the sandwich with Subway.
But you know what? God bless him if
absolutely.
He can do it.
You kidding me? Barkley probably made more in doing commercials than he did during his basketball career.
You're probably right about that.
Nick is in Old Bridge.
Wish
hello.
Somebody would offer it to me, Dan.
Absolutely. Hi, Nick.
Hi. How you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
We're good.
I'm good. So my wife is 73 years old, and she has a Shirley Temple doll still in the box when she was a kid.
Why did she never take it out of the box?
Well, she must have took it out when she was a kid.
Right.
But I'm saying she kept the box, so she still has it in the box.
Wow.
Which I understand that makes it even more valuable because you still have the original box.
Yes. Wow.
Yeah.
And any ever get it appraised?
No. My wife, she doesn't throw anything out. She keeps everything. And we have Barbie dolls from when my kids were young. And, you know, it's still in their boxes, never opened up. I mean, she doesn't throw anything out. I told her, one day, when you die, I'm going to bury everything with you because our kids don't want none of this stuff.
Wow. Well, at least check the value before you bury it with her. All right,
yeah.
Nick, thank you. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. Would anybody know who Shirley, like, would Kyle know who Shirley Temple is?
Kyle,
are you there?
No.
No.
He would not.
She was not our generation. She was our parents' generation.
Parents' generation. But Kylie might, because it's more of a girl thing to know.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. But so much of that stuff that we grew up seeing, maybe that wasn't a part of our generation, but seeing and hearing about, this generation has no idea about who they are or what they were. Even history. Even American history stuff that we grew up knowing about. Yeah, I watch those man on the street things. Will I go on college campuses and ask kids, name two continents? Name another country? Texas?
The best is asking a Hamas supporter what river and what sea.
Right. Oh, that's classic.
Now they learn because so many people made fun of
them. Yeah, somebody's made put me on the spot on the street. It's 1:44. More of the Dennis and Judi show to come. Fast traffic is next.
You know, when I was looking for flooring and carpeting for my home, there was only one place I kept on hearing about. People kept saying, go to Carpet Connection. It was worth the drive from my house because I saw they're the largest in-stock selection pretty much that you can find anywhere. And I wanted something quick. And I know that they had so much that was right in stock, whether it was wall-to-wall, area rugs, laminate, vinyl. I ended up with the vinyl, the beautiful vinyl, pretty much all over my home. And they had everything from basic to exclusive high-end lines. I got to tell you, I know this family. They've been running this business for over 20 years, and they are wonderful to do business with. Every single thing they said would happen happened. Honest, trustworthy, and they know more about flooring than anybody in the whole world. Please tell them I sent you. It's Carpet Connection. Call 732-363-0400. They're in Lakewood. You can go to carpetconnectionnj.com or call 732-363-0400.
Come. Dennis and Judi show. I'm talking about people collecting memorabilia. Yeah, I think young people do. If it's sports or if it's gaming stuff, maybe music too, but not as much as it was in the past. Like you said, social media has taken away yesterday and tomorrow, and it's only today. So you care more about...
It's just all about like immediate gratification. Don't worry about tomorrow. Don't build anything. You know, you only have 130 characters, although they've changed that now. I can't even say that anymore, Dan. Remember Twitter used to be 130 characters?
Yeah, I had somebody come over to do paint my condo in Atlantic City. And it was like 7 years ago. He said, I'll paint it, but probably be underwater in a few years. I mean, you know, if you want to go ahead and do it. Yeah.
Did you say, like, what? What do you mean,
no,
sir?
No, I knew he was... But when you present this stuff to people, like 10 years after they were wrong or 5 years after and time is passing, do you get it that you... No, I still think the world's going to end. We're all going to be underwater in 5 years. Mm-hmm. So what is it you collect? 1-800-283-1015. Barry in South Plainfield. Hi, Barry.
Hi, how you doing, Dancing Dude?
Good, how are you?
All right. When my grandfather used to own a restaurant in Mamaroneck, New York, it was called the Seven Gables Restaurant, and it was very frequented by the Yankees at the time. And when my mom was born, they gave a book to him, a baby book, that was signed by all the Yankees, including Lou Gehrig and Babe Ruth. And even Arnold Palmer was a friend of his. So, unfortunately, though, the whole thing is missing. I saw the book a long time ago, but since when my grandfather passed away, my brother had the place cleaned out, and I think somebody might have cleaned it out with it.
Oh, what a shame. All right, Barry, thank you for sharing that. Appreciate the call. Judi, a couple of questions that I thought would be just interesting side notes today, like the one, you know, if you could trade places with anyone, who could it be? Who would it be? Did you have anybody?
There are people in my personal life.
Okay, all right.
That I would want to share trade places with. No, but I've always said, like, I want to be, like, if I could be any star, I would be Jennifer Aniston.
Okay.
She has no kid. I like having kids, but... It would be fun to have like no responsibility and be like, not so gorgeous that you're a model and you're messed up, but like beautiful and everybody loves you and you're America's sweetheart.
But Brad Pitt broke your heart.
Yeah, but he smells.
Okay.
So it's okay. Which I'm sure Jen figured out.
Pretty quickly. And how many cars have you owned in your life?
Me personally?
Yeah.
Or because I've had some that weren't like, wasn't me really owning it. Like I had, my dad bought.
Oh. A lease.
You know, then my dad gave me his old this and that. Yeah, does that count?
Yeah, it was your car. Or a lease.
So I probably, oh my God.
Yeah.
But now, wait, I get a new car every 2 or 3 years because I lease. That doesn't count.
Yeah, that counts.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah.
Okay, then I've had 20 cars.
Well, I don't know.
Haven't you?
I was thinking, yeah, somewhere in the mid-teens. Be interesting to see what the average would be over a lifetime. Anyway, listen, Dennis here, and for the longest time I've heard Judy rave about guaranteed service, so I decided to try them for myself. Guaranteed service truly is the best of what they do, and they do it all. Whether it's a leaking water heater, clogged toilet, broken or faulty lights or switches, or your heating system not working properly, you'll always be in good hands with guaranteed service. Now, for a limited time, guaranteed service will tune up your heating system for only $77 and guarantee no breakdowns for the entire season, or the repair is free. No questions asked. Learn more at guaranteedservice.com.
Hey, I know what that music means, Dennis.
What, Judy?
I can't believe it, but this show has come to a close on another Tuesday, Monday's Ugly Sister.
Yes, and right about now, most of the state is drying out, the precipitation pulling away, and hopefully enough breeze will dry out those wet roads that won't freeze like crazy tonight. We have Kylie and Doyle coming up next.
What a combo.
Love you, Judy. Love, see you tomorrow.
Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
This has been the Dennis and Judy Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, Value City NJ, with 9 locations in New Jersey, or online at valuecitynj.com. Don't forget to check out the latest news and opinions from Dennis and Judy on our free app or NJ1015.com. New Jersey 101.5.